is your First Alert 5 weather with Mike Daniels.
We have got snow across our area. Winter Park looking much like winter today. A lot of fresh powder to be skied on across that area in Colorado Springs. That's a live look from the north end of town, 19 degrees. Northwest wind at 16 makes it feel like 4 degrees above zero. So yes, it's a good night to be indoors, very close to the furnace vent. In Pueblo, a live look from Big Hill. The big chill on Big Hill tonight. A few flakes across parts of town, 23 degrees. But with that wind out of the east at 9, it feels like 13 degrees. That's a live look from Woodland Park. Highway 24 in pretty good shape in most spots between the Springs and Woodland Park, but those side streets are slick and icy. Just a little bit of snow, but quite a bit of sliding around on those side streets. You'll have to utilize your winter driving skills tonight and tomorrow morning. Snow totals not very impressive in Canyon City, just a half an inch in the Springs. Flake free tonight. Southwest side of Pueblo near South Park Elementary School, 3 inches of snow. Rise, the big winner so far, with 5 inches of snow just from this afternoon into tonight. Still have that winter weather advisory from now through 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, not for El Paso County or Teller County, but from Pueblo west into eastern Fremont County, all the way south to New Mexico and all the way out east to the Kansas border. Here's what radar is showing right now. Again, not much happening across Colorado Springs. We've got a little bit of light snow across Pueblo. There's a real heavy band of snow from Highway 50 all the way back into the Wet Mountain Valley. In the Springs, most neighborhoods are dry right now. And again, the worst of this storm is certainly going to miss El Paso County. In eastern Fremont County, a little bit of light snow right now. In Pueblo County, most of the snow is on the south and southwest side of Pueblo, and that's just light snow right now. Head across southern Pueblo County, and the snow picks up in intensity. Again, there's that healthy band of snow from right around Ordway, just south of Ordway, south of Highway 96, Highway 50, all the way back into the Wet Mountain Valley. That's skinny little area, but they are getting some real good snowfall right now. Most of that snow is going to hug the Highway 50 corridor back into the Wet Mountain Valley. So again, for the rest of the night through early tomorrow morning, that is the prime target for snow here across the News 5 viewing area. Let me take you through it hour by hour. Midnight tonight, still some light snow, mainly south of Colorado Springs, all the way down to the New Mexico line. And again, you can see a lot of that snow right along Highway 50. Drier air punches in after 2-3 a.m. In fact, we'll see clearing skies by 4 and 5 a.m. across the Springs, that clearing eventually moving from north to south. Once those skies clear with this cold air mass, it is going to be frighteningly frosty early tomorrow morning across the viewing area. Snowfall totals by sunrise tomorrow morning, Pueblo, anywhere from 2 to 5 inches of snow in the Springs. Most neighborhoods will escape the snow, so I'm going with 0 to maybe an inch in some areas. Same for northern El Paso County into Teller County. There's the prime target for the snow, the Wet Mountains, Wet Mountain Valley, up to 10 inches of snow possible. So road conditions tomorrow morning, slick and icy from Pueblo south to Trinidad on I-25, 50 from Pueblo to Lamar and also Pueblo to Canyon City. Slick and icy, allow yourself a lot of extra travel time if you have to navigate those roads. Another storm system coming in late Saturday night into Sunday. This is Sunday morning. Going to start to see some snow across the Pikes Peak region. That snow will eventually press down to the south. So Saturday, the best day of your weekend. Sunday is going to be snowy and it's certainly going to get colder once again. That storm starts to clear out by late Sunday night. In Pueblo, so far 0.02 inch of water. Another unseasonably cold day today. The high only 35. In the Springs, our high temperature today is 30. That's 15 degrees colder than where we should be this time of the year. Outside right now, getting very cold. Look at that. Woodland Park already down to 8 degrees. You factor in that light breeze and it feels even colder. Monument right now with the wind, it feels like 3 degrees above zero. Forecast lows on the thermometer, the coldest air across the Pikes Peak region because it's going to clear from north to south, so more cold air there across northern and eastern El Paso County. Throw another log on the fire. Overnight low temperatures really cold, much colder than what we should have for mid-February. Afternoon high temperatures tomorrow. Not one community here across the viewing area making it above freezing tomorrow, despite mostly sunny skies throughout the day. Thankfully, we're not going to see much wind around here tomorrow, so no serious wind chill to deal with. In Colorado Springs, a big warm up on Friday, 20 degrees warmer than tomorrow, warmer still on Saturday. That's a push of breezy, mild air ahead of that next Pacific storm system. Snow on Sunday, 38, still not bad for this time of the year when we're dealing with snow, but a colder storm comes in late Monday night into Tuesday. By Tuesday, more snow and a high temperature of only 27 degrees. In Pueblo, afternoon high temperatures real cold tomorrow, but a nice recovery on Friday. Melting some of that snow at 50, mild day on Saturday, then you'll see a rain snow mix on Sunday, squeezing a dry day Monday before that next storm system comes in. Take another hit on Tuesday and some cold air Tuesday and Wednesday, highs only at 32 degrees. Canyon City tomorrow, a weather alert day. You haven't seen a whole lot of snow, but those roads will be slick and icy in some areas. Of course, we'll have team coverage on this storm tomorrow morning starting at 4:30. Woodland Park, afternoon high temperature tomorrow, awfully cold. You're defrosting Friday, warmer still Saturday, but then Saturday night into Sunday, another round of snow. Late Monday into Tuesday, here comes another one, guys.